Today, I want to share with you about living on life on dialysis. You know, this video will showcase some individuals who were diagnosed with kidney failure, including myself. And the reason we have done this video is to educate you, because sometimes when people hear that you're on dialysis, they think it's the end of your life and they have pity for you. While you are on dialysis is not the same, but you still have a life. You still have a normal life. I have been on dialysis now for 3.5 years. I don't like it, but the dialysis is allowing me to extend my life here on this earth, because the dialysis machine is really a substitute for the kidney. And you know, we go there 3 days a week. We spend 4 hours there. But the good thing for me is that I use that opportunity to do my work. I take my laptop there, and I'm there very early in the morning, and I accomplish a lot. The only thing I don't like about dialysis is that I get these needles in my arm. 2 needles, 3 days a week when I go there. So that's like 6 needles for the week. I don't like it. It still hurts when the needle goes into my arm. Some people say they don't feel it, but I still feel it. That is the worst part I don't like about being on dialysis. But I am thankful to God for giving wisdom to man to create these machines that can replace the kidneys. And I know that there's a call out there. I know in Turks and Caicos, I see there's a call. I think it was last year. I just say, who's willing to donate their kidney? And I know sometimes you may feel that, you know, you cannot live with one kidney, but there are many people in this world who are living with one kidney. And I'm encouraging you, as you look through this video, as you watch this video, to consider getting yourself tested and to see if you're willing to give one of your kidneys. We've only had one successful case so far where someone had a kidney transplant. There are only 2 areas. Once you are diagnosed with kidney failure, which is stage 5, I believe, you have to go on dialysis. And the other option is to have a kidney transplant. Those are the 2 options. Of course, with me being, you know, believing in God, I believe in miracles. I believe there's a 3rd option. And I believe that God can miraculously heal us. We just have to believe. Of course, sometimes, you know, it's hard. It's hard, you know, not believing. But we have to believe that we can be healed miraculously. So I hope you enjoy this video. I hope you have a better understanding of those persons on dialysis. There are people who've been on dialysis for almost 20 years. They look good. They continue to look good. Except, you know, they have a schedule. They have to be there 3 days a week. There's just certain food that they should eat or shouldn't eat. But not only dialysis, not only people who are on dialysis, you know. We all should be careful on what we eat and drink. And I encourage all of you to please, you know, go to the doctors at least 2x a year for a medical checkup. You know, examine yourself, because sometimes, you know, when you find out that, you know, you are in kidney failure, it's almost too late. It's almost too late. And as a result, you have to go on dialysis. Please enjoy this video.
My name is Rose Arles. I am 31 years old. I am on dialysis. I've been on dialysis for the past 6 years. And there are many reasons your kidneys can fail: blood pressure, diabetes, family history. But with me, I've been sick all my life. Like, literally, I've been fighting sickness all my life. So due to sickness and complication with medication, different medication, my kidneys just fail. But kidney failure can be prevented if diagnosed early. There are 5 stages to kidney failure. So if by the time you reach stage 3, let's say, and you don't find that out, you don't even need to do much besides change your diet and stuff like that, and the doctor will monitor you and stuff. and it can prevent you from going on dialysis. Being on dialysis changed your life. It like literally changed your life. You have to make a whole new adjustment. You have to readjust your life to suit dialysis. You understand? Like, for example, 3 days of the week, 4 hours a day. Well, let's say five, because it takes a while to put you on the machine and to take you off. So I run it about 5 hours a day. That's 15 hours a week you're hooked up to a machine. That machine drains you mentally, physically, emotionally. And to be honest, I honestly really do believe the machine does more harm than good. Yes, it keeps you alive. It keeps you alive long. I know people live on dialysis like for 20 years and 30 years. That was my biggest worry. When I first found out that I was going on dialysis, Lord, I cried. I thought I was going to die. I was like, maybe I have 5 years. But all of that is because I was misinformed. I wasn't informed. I didn't know much about dialysis. But being on dialysis, doing my researches and learning more, I realized that you can live a long life on dialysis. And some people do it. Some people live 30 years, 25 years on dialysis. But you just have to follow the guidelines, the restriction, what you eat, how you eat, when you drink, how much you drink, all of that. And follow your doctor's prescription. You know, you drink your medication and stuff. All of that help you to live longer. I don't say better, but longer. Because you get sleepless night, pain all over your body. It has a whole lot of different side effects. It's not just the kidneys feel like it causes a whole lot of other stuff. And like I say, it can be prevented. So if you know any of those things I listed earlier, you have any of them, it's good for you to keep on checking on yourself and take the necessary measures, you know, to prevent going on dialysis. Prevention is better than cure. So do that, proper diet, exercise, and avoid going on the machine. Avoid life on the machine. That would be my advice to anybody.
Hi, my name is Gladstone Pratt, and I've been a dialysis patient for the last 10 years. And it's not an easy thing to live with dialysis. And for those of you who don't understand what dialysis is, it means that you have damaged kidneys, the kidney which is supposed to flush your entire body. So what it does is, the understanding of it when you have dialysis means that your kidney is not working properly. And when your kidney is not functioning properly, it causes strain on the body. Now, with that being said, if you are on dialysis, you are supposed to take your medication, and everything that you do, your water intake, your food intake, has to be done gradually. Has to take your time. Everything is supposed to be done in moderation. Now, for those of you who don't like to go to the doctor, I suggest that you do go get a checkup to find out whether your kidneys are working, your heart don't have a problem, or this don't have a problem, or the next thing don't have a problem, because there's sometimes that these things just sneak up on you. And when I say sneak up on you, when the doctor tells you that you have this or you have that because you wasn't taking care of yourself, then that means that you have to take better care of yourself. There's nobody else responsible for taking care of you. And being in that position, because you don't want to be like me or some of the other people, that when we went to the doctor and we find out that we have kidney problem, we were kind of taken back, or we were kind of shocked, because here it is, you have this kidney problem and all of the things that you have to go through. When I first got it, I have a sister who's a registered nurse, and I have a cousin that's a doctor. And I got pamphlets from both of them because I didn't understand it. It scared the hell out of me. But after talking to them, and they trying to explain it the best that they possibly could, they said to me, you have to do everything in moderation. You also have to take whatever tablets they give you, that you have to take your medication. It's not easy, but after a while, you get used to it. You still want to live, so you got to do what you got to do to stay alive. And that's my take on it.
I have been now on dialysis for the past 14 years. It was not an easy journey for me. I started sweating. I went into the hospital, I came out. Still didn't know what was wrong with me. So I decided to go and get another opinion. So I went to the Bahamas to my sister. Went to the doctor. For 3 weeks, still couldn't find the problem. One afternoon, I got so ill. I called my sister and I said to her, I need to go to the hospital. She took me to the hospital. This time I was disfigured. And this lady came out and she said, Miss Ramsey, what you doing here? And my sister said, I am here to bring one of my sisters who was ill. So then she said, I don't know this one. So she said, start calling the name and I'll tell you which one it is. So the first name she called was Lisa, my sister better continue calling names. Then she said, this is Diana. So I knew that I was disfigured. She went in the back, and no matter time, she was back to the front that I went, and the doctor came. And he looked at me and asked me three questions. Do you smoke? Do you drink? And was I saved? And I said, yes, sir, I don't drink and I don't smoke, but I'm saved. Take the blood. Another time, I just sat there. In a couple minutes later, I was out of it. I remember them putting a mask over me and tying me up to a bed. Meanwhile, after that, I caught myself and decided to keep me overnight. I went on the ward and stayed in the hospital for a week. After 2 weeks, I was in a lift of 2 years. Went to the Princess Margaret Hospital. I was very lifted on the list for dialysis. But even the Turks and Caicos, you don't have to be very listed to have the surgery done for dialysis once you know you are dialysis patient. So I spent 1 year in hospital. Thank God for my family, thank God for friends that prayed for me while I was there. I remember being in hospital and saying to God some years ago, there's places I want to go and people I want to see. That's when he took me into the hospital. And I really see who God really was when I said those words. He showed me. And stayed there. I had the surgery and I came back to Nassau. Went back to Freeport. I had a catheter, I had a graft in my arm, worked very well. My brother-in-law at that time took me every morning to dialysis. My sister would pick me up. And I did that, and then I started coming to Provo, like on. When it was holidays and school and at Christmas time, I would come to Provo and go back to Freeport. Laying down one day in my bed, I got a phone call from a lady, and she called me and she says, She got the number from my son after traveling on a flight from Miami to Turks and Caicos. And so my son gave her the number, she called me. She asked to speak to me. And I said, this is she. So then she asked me three questions. And I said, no, mom. Yes, mom. She said, are you sure? I said, yes, mom. She prayed. And then we hung up. A couple of days later, after that, I was laying down across the bed and it rained. The wind was coming down, pouring rain. I fell asleep. And I heard the Lord say, pack up your things and go back to prove it. I said, God, me, I never want to see that place again. So my sister came home that afternoon, I told her about it. So she said, God, it is God. Listen to this word and believe say. So I said, tell Uncle B I'm going back to Togo. He said, no, you tell him with your own mouth. So I did. So he said, no one asked you to leave. You don't have to go, you always welcome here. And I told him what I had heard from the Lord. I packed up and I came back to Togo. And there was a clinic here in Togo. The lady here, Robinson, Ricardo and Eddie and Santa, they took very good care of me here. And then back to Freeport. When I went back to Freeport, Winston would always call me and say, man, you need to come back, you need to come back. So I came back and I stayed. 2011, I came home for good. But what I want to say to you have to be careful. Sometimes it happens in different ways. I had a swelling. Some persons, they just gain weight. Some people lose weight.
My name is Shaniqua, and I've been on dialysis for 10 years now. Dialysis has affected my life in numerous ways, some positive and some negative. I'm better able to take care of my body after learning about the relationship between the kidneys and the heart. Some days I'm unable to work after treatment because dialysis leaves you drained at times and after you need a lot of rest to recuperate. However, some days are also pretty good and I'm able to actually get right up and go to work. There was a period of almost about 3 years that I was unable to work due to excruciating back pain and joint pains. But once I did parathyroidectomy surgery, that corrected the problem right away. Once you start to do dialysis from kidney disease, a lot of times you end up getting a lot of other sickness or maybe an associated disease that would come as a result of the kidney disease. But it varies from person to person based on what caused your disease and as well as how well you take care of your body. Some persons do dialysis because of hypertension or uncontrolled hypertension. Some had to do it because of lupus maybe. And then there's also diabetes that causes kidney disease. And then there's also the factor of damage to your kidney caused by trauma from an accident. At first, dialysis affected me mentally and I was also depressed for a while. But once I realized that without dialysis, I would die, and once I decided that I was going to follow the doctor's orders, the quality of my life changed, and it's fairly good. Another thing that I would tell you is medications. You have to take a lot of medications. Some patients have to take 2 meds. Some of them have to take up to 8 medications. It just all depends on what caused your kidney damage. Once you're affected by the disease, you're better able to explain what dialysis is and what to tell other persons to look out for to avoid coming on to dialysis, which is to get your annual checkup, eat balanced meals, exercise and follow the doctor's orders, take your medications if you have a condition that threatens your kidney health. When I started dialysis, other patients encouraged me. They told me that it was not the end of the world, and so far I've been here 10 years on treatment, and I think it's going pretty good. Another thing that they told me was to take care of myself so as to avoid further damage to my heart, get my regular checkups, follow doctor's orders, and be sure to take the medication as prescribed. Generally in the Turks and Caicos, we come from a family of people that pray, we believe in God. And I would definitely say the utmost important thing that has gotten me through the past 10 years is knowing God and being able to pray when times were very rough. And so I think as long as you continue to pray and hold on to your faith, I think everything will definitely be okay.
I hope you have an appreciation for those persons on dialysis. We live a life normal just like you who don't have dialysis, except, you know, we come to the hospital 3 days a week, hook up to a machine, but people still have a normal life. And what you can do is to pray for us. What you can do is consider donating a kidney to someone so that they can get a kidney transplant and they don't have to go on dialysis. But there is life on dialysis. Now, there are some people, of course, whose career has changed, whose income has changed as a result of dialysis, because they no longer can work full-time. They have to, you know, take time out of their schedule to come on dialysis, which is 4 hours a day, so that's 12 hours. And so they don't have a full-time job. And sometimes the dialysis can strain you. You could be very, very tired after dialysis. And so you kind of really cannot function. So those are some of the cons of being on dialysis. But the great thing about it is that your life has been extended. You have time with your family. You have time to, you know, to give back to the community. And you know, we have time to praise God. And so I hope that you enjoy this video. Remember to subscribe to my YouTube channel at Drexel Seymour. Thank you very much.